In this video, we'll be working with a tiny 8-bit, 8-pin microcontroller, Microchip's PIC12 F683. We'll learn how to program it by using PicKit 3 module and MPLAB X IDE. And we'll understand how to configure and use its digital I/O pins by writing C code first for blinking an LED and then using a push button to control the LED. Let's check our circuit for our digital I/O example, blinking an LED. Here you can see that I'm using an external 5-volt power supply for powering the microcontroller. Actually, it's a 5-volt regulator connected to a 12-volt adapter. The reason I'm using an external power supply instead of PicKit 3's supply is that I had many problems when I wanted to download the code to the microcontroller with the MPLAB IDE. Now let's see the pinouts of both the PicKit 3 and the PIC12 F683 so that we understand the diagram better. When we look at the pinouts, we can see that it's very easy to figure out the connections. Pin 1, the MCLR pin of the PicKit 3, is going to be connected to the MCLR pin of the microcontroller. Since we are using an external power supply, we will not be connecting the pin 2 of the PicKit 3. We'll connect the ground pin of the PicKit 3 to the common ground on our breadboard or the VSS. Pin 4 of the PicKit 3 is going to be connected to the ICSB dot on the microcontroller. And pin 5 of the PicKit 3, which is the ICSB clock, is going to be connected to the ICSB clock on the microcontroller. Pin 6 won't be connected. And it's recommended to use a 10K resistor between the MCLR and the VDD pins. So we have this resistor connected right here. And the LED that we are going to blink will be connected to the GP4 over a 1 kilo ohm resistor. Actually, you can use another pin such as GP2 or GP5. GP3 cannot be used since it can only be used as input. I'll be using MPLAB IDE for programming the PIC microcontrollers with the PicKit 3. So you have to go to the microchip.com and you have to download the MPLAB IDE. So if you click on the latest downloads, you can see the list here. And you can choose for your operating system. The additional thing that you need to download and install is the compiler. And we are going to be installing XE8 compilers for the MPLAB IDE. So if you go to the downloads page, you can go to the compiler downloads and you can choose the XE8 compiler here. The installations are very straightforward, so I don't think that you are going to experience any problems there. If you've downloaded and installed MPLAB IDE and XE8 compiler, we can create our first project. We are going to click on File, we are going to click on New Project, we will select Standalone Project, we are going to click on Next. We are going to choose our device, which is 683, so we can choose it from this drop-down, and we are going to choose our PicKit 3 as the tool, and then we are going to click on Next. Again, we are going to click on Next, and we will be selecting our XE8 compiler, and click on Next again. We are going to write down a project name, like example here, and I'm going to click on Finish. So in the example project, you can click on the source files, you can click on New, and you can click on main.c. So here you can name your file whatever you want. So let's say example 1. I'm just creating this in order to show it to you, and then we are going to click on Finish. And we will be having our example1.c file here, and we can modify it as we want. So I'm going to continue with the Blink LED project that I've already created. So we can see that we have the new main.c file here, and the code is already inserted. So let's go through it. We are going to have this include xc.h line in the beginning. And then we are going to be configuring the configuration bits. So we can do it from the configuration bits window. And we can do the changes that we want in here, like choosing the oscillator type, like enabling or disabling the watchdog timer, and etc. and etc. And then after doing those settings, you can click on the generate source code to output. And you can copy and paste this section into your code. Since I have done my configurations already, I won't be doing that. I'll go to my new main.c file. In this line, I've selected the internal oscillator, watchdog timer is off, power up timer enable bit is off, MCLR is off, code protection is off, data code protection is off, brownout detection is disabled. And here we tell the compiler at which speed the microcontroller is working. So let's check this in the datasheet. So you can see that for our microcontroller, the internal oscillator frequency is 4 MHz by default. That's why we have the setting here as 4 MHz to tell the compiler at which speed the microcontroller is working. Then I define two integers, I and j. I'll be using them in loops. And here I'm creating a delay function, which is getting an integer as a parameter. And in our main function, I'm setting all the I/O ports as output. To set a port as output, you have to set its value to 0. And if you want to set it as input, you have to set it as 1. Actually, this is the opposite that we have for the MSP430, if you remember. Here, I would like to mention one other thing. In the project, when you go to the libraries and select this folder, you can see that there's a whole list of the registers here. And if we look at to our TRIS IO register, you can see that we have 6 IOs, and they can be configured separately as well. So I can write here TRIS IO 4. Since I'm going to be using the GP4 as output, it's going to be the same as well. So that won't cause any problem. So by this line, I'll be setting only GP4 as output. Here I'm setting the GP4 pin to 1, meaning that it's going to be high. And then I'm creating a delay of 1 second here. We are going to see the delay function. And I'm going to set GP4 to 0, so it's going to be off. And then we are going to have a delay of 1 millisecond as well. So if you look at the delay function, the double underscore delay underscore MS intrinsic function, we are calling it for only 1 milliseconds. And in a for loop, we are increasing this delay with the parameter that we sent to the delay function. So if I send 1000 to the delay function, I'm going to have a delay of 1 second. The reason that I'm not using the intrinsic function itself in the while one loop is that it's requiring a constant. If I want to play with the duration, if I want to make it a variable, I'll have to use a separate function. Now let's take a look at our setup. As you can see, we have our PicKit 3 connected to our laptop, and the 6 cables coming from it are entered into the breadboard, and we have made our connections according to the diagram that we saw. And as I mentioned previously, I have a voltage regulator here, which has 12 volts in the input, like 12.3, and on its output, it has 5 volts. So I'm feeding the breadboard with 5 volts. I've got this 10K ohm resistor between the MCLR and the VDD pins, and my LED is connected to GP4, and over a 1K resistor, it's connected to the ground. So as you can see, the LED is already blinking because I had already downloaded the code on the microcontroller. So let's change the delays in order to observe it. Let's change it to 2 seconds. And by the way, you have to save the code, and then you're going to click on build. And we have our output right here. And we see that build is successful. And then we are going to click on this make and program device button. And let's see the log. It's connecting to the MPLAB PicKit 3. So it's warning me for connecting the device that has been chosen in the MPLAB. So I'm clicking on OK. So you can see that the device has been erased, and I get this fail to program device. Okay, I have just disconnected and connected the PicKit 3, and now you can see that programming verify is complete, and you can observe that the LED is on for 2 seconds and then it's off for 2 seconds. Let's reduce this number. Let's make it 300 milliseconds, for example. Save it. Let's build it. And then let's load it on the microcontroller. Okay, it's complete. And you can see that it's been blinking faster. Now in the second example, I've added a push button on the circuit. And as you can see, when I press the button, I'm going to have 5 volts on the other side of it. And I've connected this push button to GP2. Now you can see in the code that I have made another setting which sets the GP2 as an input. And in this line, I'm making sure that it's not selected as an analog input. Actually, I had worked with the ADC on this microcontroller, so that's why if I didn't put this line, my code was not working. So that's why I added this line. And in the while one loop, I'm saying that if GP2 input is equal to 1, so if the button is pressed, then GP4 is going to be high, meaning that the LED will be on. And otherwise, it will be off. So let's build. And let's download the code to the microcontroller. Connecting. And the programming is complete. So when I press the button, I'm expecting the LED to be on. So let's see it. You can see that we have 5 volts and our LED is on. This was the end of the video. I hope it's been useful for you. If you have any questions or comments, please write them in the comment section. Thank you for watching and see you in another video.